now. People will say she's just a fool and won't survive. She gave it away. Gone with the early morning call. She knew they lied. Down, she just broke down. Tying her hair, fixing her blouse. Down, she just broke down.
We are in Mykonos, which is so famous all over the world, together with Santorini, the two most important islands of the Cyclades. The Cyclades is a group of 56 islands, but 24 of them are not inhabited. The Greek word Cyclades, Cyclades, is coming out of the word kyklos, which means circle. So all the Cyclades are forming a circle around the sacred island of Apollo, which is Delos. Length of 86 kilometers, this island, and 8,000 inhabitants. But in summertime, we'll have a lot of cruise boats. Sometimes the population arrives up to 30,000 people. The waters are very clear, they are transparent, they have this deep green color, Rhenia. You see this island on the left is Rhenia, Delos is on the right, a little bit further, two islands, one next to the other. We cannot see the archaeological site of Delos because it's on the other side, and this is the biggest archaeological site in Europe, protected by UNESCO. Rhenia was not inhabited in ancient years. It was used for the two purifications. I will explain when telling you the history what are the two purifications. And nowadays we have only some yachts that they are going to the beaches of Rhenia, and shepherds that live with their animals. This is St. John Beach, a very small one. Now you still have a peaceful sea at the north, and here the sea is not so calm.
The second and Alexander the Great are coming here. They are installed for two centuries, and it is then that the island is losing this very big religious meaning and becomes a very big economical and commercial center. It is then, at the 3rd century BC, that it is proclaimed as the first duty-free port all over the world.
Paradise, super paradise, Elia. We have the beach of Paranga.
It's 1 o'clock. He didn't call. Didn't get back. She tried to unlock all of her dreams that she denied and turned to black. Down, she just broke down, touching his face.
card. No flash, please, I remind you. The influence of the West is the colors. It separates the altar from the main church. This is the main door. Always on the right, we have Christ. Always next to Christ, we have St. John the Baptist, who's represented like an angel with wings, because he was the most important person, human being, together with the Virgin. On the left, this is the miraculous icon of the Virgin. I was telling you, with the faith offerings, the eye have installed here. Thank you, jewelry, the golden leaves. The face is very much because I remind you that it was found into the sea, 16th century, into the depth of the sea. And the Assumption, next, we send the longest next to the Virgin, with the icon which is representing to whom is dedicated the church. So the work is excellent, and the same technique is the bishop's throne and the pulpit on the right. Look, each icon has an oil lamp which is made out of silver, and on the right we have a lot of offerings, oil lamps, all of them offered. This is the one with the boat I was telling you. Look at the boat here. And over there hanging at the entrance, other oil lamps, all of them are offerings of people that were saved. The main chandelier here, which is lightened when we have big celebrations. Christ is Pantocrator, the God of the universe at the dome. Few windows so that few light can enter. Prophets, all the disciples always around the dome, and at the four spherical triangulars, we have either the four evangelists, or four scenes of the life of Christ, the resurrection, the birth, the transfiguration, or the baptism. Only this was a solution that gave the architects of St. Sophia how to put a circular dome on a rectangular construction. The solution was given by the four spherical triangulars that are taking all the power of the dome and are giving it to the lines of the cross. Now here you realize that the seats are very uncomfortable. You can stand here just to get some rest, or you can sit, and they are very narrow as well. Because our services are lasting from 3 hours to 10 hours sometimes, and if the seats were comfortable, you could get asleep immediately. Now, down below you see here there are tombs. This is the original pavement of the 16th century. And here are tombs of previous monks that passed from here and are buried in the same the church they have served. Here the bishop's throne, you see Christ is at the second coming, the only place icon that would not have an oil lamp. I mentioned before, Christ without mercy, because he's coming as a judge. And here is the pulpit. All these paintings you see here, the iconography is influenced from the West, as you can easily see, and we have an influence of the Venetians. All the churches are divided by two rows of columns in three parts. This is the Holy Trinity. In bigger churches have five parts. The columns are monolithic, marble. The capital imitates the Corinthian style. In other monasteries that are more rich, we have the capital which is made out by marble and in relief. But this is a poor monastery, although whatever you see, gold is gold, apart from the chandelier here, which is bronze, according to the tradition. But all the other oil lamps are golden and silver, and all of them are offered by the pilgrims. Now, we then come out, you can see the fireworks I was telling you, the Byzantine, which is a reality, it's not Byzantine, it's West reality, and the other one,
φοβάμαι πως τα χρόνια που θα ρωθούν πιασμένο θα με βρουν στο παρελθόν σου. Το βλέμμα σου κρυμμένο στους καπνούς, τα χείλη μου θα καίν απ' το σφίγμο σου. Θα σου φωνάζω μα δεν θα μ' ακούς. Κι έτσι θα περνάει ο χρόνος μόνο. Κι έτσι θα κυλάει η ζωή. Αυτό που ζήσαμε δεν θα μετράει.
Kalolivadi, we have mainly young girls, very beautiful ones, that are coming on scaffoldings, that they're jumping, they're making acrobatic shows, they're falling into the sea. Now, just have a look, Kalolivadi is here on the right. Look what a nice beach. Kalolivadi means the beautiful field. Can you see? And hotels.
Είσαι τώρα πλάι μου εσύ. Φοβάμαι πως οι μέρες που θα έρθουν πιο δύσκολες δεν θα έχω συναντήσει. Μάτια μου ξανά δε θα σε δουν. Τα μάτια σου ποτέ δε βρήκαν λύση. Θα σου φωνάζω μα δε θα γυρίσεις. Κι έτσι θα περνάει ο χρόνος μόνο. Κι έτσι θα κυλάει η ζωή. Αυτό που ζήσαμε δεν θα μετράει. Δεν είσαι τώρα πλάι μου. Δεν είσαι τώρα πλάι μου εσύ. Κι έτσι θα περνάει ο χρόνος μόνο. Κι έτσι θα κυλάει η ζωή. Αυτό που ζήσαμε δεν θα μετράει. Δεν είσαι τώρα πλάι μου εσύ.
Καλά.
five churches. We have the Virgin, it is the dome, it's dedicated to the Virgin. From the other side you see the two crosses. Down below we have Saint Sozon, who's Christ, that brings the salvation. We have Saint Eustathios, Saint Anastasia, and Saint Anargyri as well. From each side is different. Its architecture is unique. It's one of the most famous all over the Cyclades. It's made by an unknown architect, and you will notice when we make the tour of the church that each side is different from the other. It's called the Paraportiani. Porta means door. So it is next to the door, which I'm going to show you in a minute, a very small door that if you open it, you jump into the sea. Because here were the was the castle at the edge of the church on the left and right. This is part of the Venetian fortification of the 16th century, which was surrounding the whole town. So it is the only one which has a white dome, and it's next to the door of the castle. That's why it's called Paraportiani. Para in porta. Next to the door is the meaning. From here you can see this house of Captain and Pirate Maluchos, 18th century. From the other side, which is looking to the sea, it has a small room like an extension, and there he was transporting all his treasuries, and he was watching from there if enemies were coming to steal what he has stolen. Small door. The entrance, two churches. Sometimes the churches are more than the houses.
Σε κοιτώ, θέλω να σου πω όσα δεν είπα. Πως παραδόθηκα εγώ σε αυτό το χωρισμό. Κάθε φορά που με κοιτάς, μέσα μου ξυπνάς μια καταιγίδα. Ψάχνει λιμάνι το κορμί, και εσύ είσαι η αφορμή. Μα δεν γίνεται να θυμάται ακόμα, η καρδιά να πονάει δεν γίνεται. Αφού λένε πως ό,τι πληγώνει στο χρόνο αφήνεται, κι ό,τι αλλάζει, αλλάζει μόνο για καλό. Δεν γίνεται, υποτίθεται πως σε ξεπέρασα, μα δεν γίνεται. Και το κάθε σημάδι στο σώμα αρνιέται, δεν σβήνεται. Και τις νύχτες σου φωνάζει, σ' αγαπώ.
Κάθε φορά που με κοιτάς, μέσα μου χτυπάς την ίδια πόρτα. Ανοίγω μες στα σκοτεινά ξανά και είσαι εδώ. Κάθε φορά που σε κοιτώ, τυφλώνουν το μυαλό τα ίδια φώτα. Και πάλι ψάχνεις σαν τρελή η αγάπη να κρυφτεί. Μα δεν γίνεται να θυμάται ακόμα η καρδιά να πονάει, δεν γίνεται. Αφού λένε πως ό,τι πληγώνει στο χρόνο αφήνεται. Κι ό,τι αλλάζει, αλλάζει μόνο για καλό. Δεν γίνεται. Υποτίθεται πως σε ξεπέρασα, μα δεν γίνεται. Και το κάθε σημάδι στο σώμα αρνιέται, δεν σβήνεται. Και τις νύχτες σου φωνάζει, σ' αγαπώ.